Okay, guys, so we always love to hear, and we talk a lot about Victorinoxes being so useful to the woodsman. So today, I'm going to be doing a little thing called the Victorinox Challenge, and I'm just going to be seeing what all this little Victorinox can do. And if this goes well, I may also do a few other Victorinox challenges throughout the summer, just kind of show and test what these little Victorinoxes can do, and just how handy these little guys can be out here in the woods, and showing you guys some real life, kind of general purpose, and hopefully educational and entertaining videos about what all these little Victorinoxes can do. Now, for my Victorinox challenge, I'm going to be using the Victorinox Huntsman because I think that this is one of the best outdoor tools, or one of the best outdoor Victorinoxes. It's not a Swiss tool, obviously. Love Swiss tools, but I think that this is probably the best non-Swiss tool Victorinox for the woods. There are a lot of other options to go with. You kind of just have to find what you like the most, but I think that this is personally the best. So anyways, guys, I'm going to bring you in a little bit closer and just kind of show you guys the process. I'm probably not going to do completely like every little cut on this because it just ends up taking a lot of time. But as always, guys, before we get into this, please do not forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe so you can see more awesome Alaskan outdoor and EDC content just like this. Now let's get into it. The sun is right over my head that way, so that's why it's a little bit bright, but I did want to talk to you guys and try to show you guys that is what the, or how the tri-stick came out. Just a quick little tri-stick with this little Victorinox, and actually I decided to use the pen blade here, or the smaller blade here, because it's a little bit more nimble, and primarily it's thinner. And of course, as I'm sure I don't have to explain, but will explain, the thinner a knife is, or a thinner a blade is, the easier it is to push through things. So I could make this tri-stick a lot faster. I actually did it in about, I think, 5 minutes-ish. Did this in these notches and stuff because I had that thin blade and it could move really fast and it could really be easily pushed through the material I was cutting through. So anyways, it performed very well, and definitely when it comes to little tasks like this, the Victorinox performs very, very well, and I really love just the way this thing performs. It has, like I said, that smaller pen blade is one of my favorite features on Victorinoxes because it is such a handy little blade. And you'll find like a million uses, especially even out here in the woods, for that tiny little pen blade. Now, I will say in the later Victorinox challenges, I will use this big blade, but in all honesty, for the most part, most of what you need to be, or what needs to be done with a Victorinox itself, can be done with this tiny little pen blade. Now, I will say another thing you guys probably noticed was the fact that I was actually putting some pressure on the spine of the blade, and I definitely do that with caution because, of course, this is a slip joint knife, or everything on this Victorinox in particular is a slip joint, so there are no locks on it. But another thing I wanted to show is that just because it is a slip joint does not mean that you can't actually apply pressure to the back of the blade. You just kind of have to get used to how to do it, because you have to put pressure when you're actually pushing through the material, but stop putting pressure the moment you go through the material you're cutting. If you don't do that, then there's a pretty high chance that you will actually collapse the blade on your fingers, which would give you a cut, which would suck. So do use caution when applying pressure to the back of a slip joint blade, but it can be done. Trust me, guys. So anyways, that's basically all I have to say about this Victorinox challenge, other than there will be more probably to follow because I think this will go well, but primarily you guys help decide that by views, likes, comments. If you guys want to see more of this, please let me know. As always, guys, that's all for now. God bless, and I'm out.